They slip and fall, you pay the price. Con artists are ripping off local stores and pretending to fall and then get hurt.
And you end up paying for it at the cash register. Tonight, Fox 6 investigator Brian Paulson confronting one of the women accused of operating a massive slip and fall ring in Milwaukee. Brian?
That's right, Ted. Mary, around the country, fraudulent slip and fall claims are up 25% since 2008. And federal records we obtained show one of the most elaborate slip and fall rings in America was operating right here in Milwaukee.
They'd like to talk to you about what you guys were doing.
No, okay, get on my face. Okay.
When I tried to talk to Kimball Lewis,
I got my kids. Get the out of my face.
You might say she gave me the slip.
Bye.
But the 23-year-old mother of two can't hide from this. Federal court records show Lewis admitted to taking part in a scheme to defraud retail stores out of hundreds of thousands of dollars by submitting false claims for injuries arising from accidents that never took place.
It's easy money.
Insurance investigators call it the slip and fall.
Oh, it's more of a quick sit down.
Mark Sakalaris is a special agent for the National Insurance Crime Bureau, which maintains a database of questionable claims submitted to thousands of insurance companies across the country. According to the NICB, 2010 was a record year for phony falls.
It's happening even more frequently now as the economy worsens. People are trying to find alternative ways of bringing revenue in.
Accidental slips, trips, and falls are a huge liability for any retail store, and scammers know it. So they exploit a store's willingness to quickly settle claims by staging fake accidents that are virtually impossible to disprove.
Can you say that these people didn't get hurt when they fell? No, you really can't.
Unless they're caught on store surveillance.
There she is.
Looks right down
at them, yeah.
That's what happened in Phoenix, Arizona, where a shopper appears to wipe out on something left in the aisle. But back up the tape and you'll see her accomplice intentionally sets an object on the floor, then looks around to see if anyone noticed. A few minutes earlier, another camera catches him buying the offending object, a hot dog.
It's very odd to have evidence that good.
In Florida, a 72-year-old woman pours liquid on the floor in the cosmetics aisle of a grocery store, then returns a few minutes later to stage her fall. She wipes her shoe in the puddle, then deliberately sits down, leans back, even fixes her hair, before her partner in crime goes searching for help. Seconds later, store workers come running to her aid, and paramedics aren't far behind. The execution was flawless, until they got greedy and asked for $300,000.
That's bold. I mean, that's extremely bold to go and to that extent to think you're going to get away with it.
It works more often than you might think.
A lot of these are paid. Even the ones that are caught on video are still paid. A lot of them, not all of them, but a lot of them are still paid.
The insurance company pays the claim, but a spokesman for the National Insurance Fraud says you pay the price.
Fake slip and fall injuries come back to all of us in higher prices at the department store or at the grocery store. This is money out of our pockets in a lousy economy when average Americans are just trying to make a decent living. It's not fair.
The scammers usually work in teams, but few are as prolific as a band of women accused of fleecing dozens of Milwaukee area retailers.
I got my kids. Get the out of my face.
Kimball Lewis is just one of the players implicated by federal investigators in a scheme to rip off big box stores like Menards, TJ Maxx, Target, Michaels, Pick and Save, and more. According to court records filed by the U.S. Postal Inspector, Lewis's mother, Michelle Taylor, was the ringleader. Between September of 2007 and March of 2009, investigators say Taylor and her associates submitted 65 fraudulent claims seeking more than $200,000.
It's the same group, and they keep hitting and they keep hitting.
25 of those claims were submitted to Chicago-based Zurich North America Insurance, and it was Zurich's internal investigators who discovered that 8 of the claims contained an identical invoice from Great Lakes Radiology. 5 claims used identical receipts from Wheaton Franciscan, and 2 claims used the exact same receipt from Aurora Medical Center. In fact, 6 of the slip and fall claims were for accidents that occurred the very same day.
You think you have a right to walk into places and pretend you've fallen and hurt yourself?
When have I did that?
Lewis and her mother told investigators they got help from a woman named Deborah Woody, who was a student in Sanford Brown's medical billing program. Woody allegedly had blank medical files on a flash drive, which were edited to create the fake documents submitted with each claim. According to Zurich, 24 of the claims were faxed from Sanford Brown's West Allis campus. three of them within 44 minutes of each other, and each for roughly $3,000 to $5,000.
A lot of money. And this is just one group in one area. There's more than just this group that was doing this in Milwaukee County. You know, these are the only ones that got caught.
Even when they do get caught, criminal charges are rare.
Prosecutors will save the resources for what they consider more violent crimes, such as drugs and burglary, murders and shooting.
Federal investigators named 16 different people who may or may not have been willing participants in Milwaukee's slip and fall ring.
I got my kids. Get the out of my face.
But so far, they've arrested just one, Kimball Lewis's mother, Michelle Taylor.
Until these people start going to prison for this, you're going to see them continue to do it.
And consumers will continue to take the fall.
Michelle Taylor and Deborah Woody are both serving prison time for unrelated fraud convictions. Last fall, federal prosecutors filed criminal charges against Taylor for the slip and falls, but then quickly dropped the case. A source close to the investigation tells me it's now before a grand jury, and that indictment could be coming in the near future. Now, Kimball Lewis has not been charged with anything, despite her alleged admission to U.S. Postal Inspector.
You use the term rare, but how often really do these slip and fall scammers get charged with anything?
Very rarely, really, if ever, do they get charged. The Milwaukee District Attorney's Office couldn't think of a single slip and fall fraud case they've ever charged. And aside from the Michelle Taylor case, federal prosecutors in Milwaukee didn't know of any other cases either. The NICB says they would like to see Wisconsin do what some other states have done, and that's to create positions for investigators and prosecutors whose primary mission is stamping out insurance fraud. But, of course, that all costs money and budgets are tight.
Would have loved to have been in court when a jury saw that 72-year-old woman lie down and fix her hair. She got jail time.
That is my understanding, correct, yeah.
Brian Paul's a great story. Thanks. Mary?
All the